हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, गुड मॉर्निंग। वेलकम टू द ऑनलाइन क्लासेस ऑफ आरसीए एजुकेशन हब बंसू। एंड लेट वी स्टार्ट क्लास 11th, चैप्टर नंबर 3, प्लांट किंगडम। सो बिफोर दैट वी डिस्कस्ड दैट व्हाट इज द मेन बेसिस फॉर द क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ द प्लांट किंगडम। नाउ इन दिस चैप्टर वी डिस्कस इन डिटेल अबाउट द एल्गी, ब्रायोफाइटा, टेरिडोफाइटा, जिम्नोस्पर्म्स एंड एंजियोस्पर्म्स। And let's first start our first class algae. Okay, so as the algae containing the organisms or the simplest plants which possess undifferentiated plant body. Okay, what is the meaning of undifferentiated plant body or thallus? It means the plant body do not be differentiated into root, stem and leaves. Okay, it is like a thallus. For example, if you are talking about the hollow box having a round shape, okay, inside that it having the daughter and number of mother colony, okay. So in the same way, we are not able to identify the root, stem and leaves. So it is a thallus like forms, okay. So simplest plants included under the class algae. Okay, now let me discuss the general characteristics or the features of the algae. One, plant body is thallus, okay, which may be multicellular, colonial, filamentous or parenchymatous. It means this we already discussed ki plant body jo hai wo thallus like hai, okay. It means it should not be or it is not differentiated into the root, stem and leaves, as well as it may be multicellular, consist of more than one cell. Maybe colonial, it means if you are talking about the wall box, okay, that is colonial. Filamentous, filament like structure are there, for example spirogyra, etc. The second one is that they are usually aquatic. Mostly the algae are living or survive into the water, okay. As they are survive into the water, so they are aquatic, but some of them are found in moist. It means the place where water or the moisture is present in the terrestrial habitat, like tree trunks, okay, wet rocks and moist soil. So except aquatic or except water, they are present in those places also where moisture is present in large amount. Okay, next thing, vascular tissue are absent. So here let me discuss, because these algae are growing inside the water, okay. These are growing inside the water, so there is no necessity of the xylem and phloem, okay. There is no necessity of the xylem or tertiary elements for transportation of the water. So vascular bundles or vascular tissue are totally absent in the algae. And if we discuss about the mode of reproduction, so algae can reproduce by the three means of reproduction. One is vegetatively they can reproduce through the fragmentation. So in fragmentation, if you can cut the simple organism into two or three pieces, then each piece develop into a new individual. Asexual mode of reproduction, it is takes place with the help of juice spores, okay. And sexual mode of reproduction is three types. Isogamous type, it is takes place in spirogyra. It is known as isogamous type of sexual reproduction because here both gametes are similar in their appearance, or we can say that both gametes are morphologically similar, okay. Both gametes are morphologically similar. Morphologically similar. So that type of reproduction is known as isogamous type of reproduction, which is takes place in spirogyra. And isogamous of reproduction, in this both gametes are morphologically different. And in oogamous type of reproduction, one male gamete is smaller and motile, whereas female gamete is larger and non motile, okay. So this type of reproduction, mode of reproduction, is known as oogamous type. Is that clear? So this is all over about the general features of the algae. Later on, algae are divided into the three classes, which we discuss in the next chapter, next lecture. Okay, goodbye.